climate change in Sudan has a very negative impact on the livelihoods, sustainable livelihoods of the communities, because Sudan lies in the arid and semi-arid zones of Africa, the central parts of Africa. And most of the communities, I mean, more than 80% in the traditional sector, depends on rainfall. So for the last 30 or 40 years, the rainfall has been changing in intensity and duration, and we have had so many droughts in Sudan.
Keep going.
Affected negatively these sustainable livelihoods of Sudan. So Sudan has prepared NAPA in 2004, at identifying at that time 5 different ecological zones, including now South Sudan, the Equatorial province, state, from this desert to semi-desert in sandy soil to savanna on clay soils in South Darfur to a semi-arid area in North Kordofan, and again savanna on clay soils in the Darif, and the River Nile state as one of the semi-arid zones. So those 5 states at that time, the NAPA adaptation project started with the most vulnerable communities, providing water, improving the water management, so water harvesting in 2 states, and improving access to either surface water like in River Nile or underground water like in North Kordofan. There was a special emphasis on the small farmers, especially women in North Kordofan and in South Darfur, where women were given preferential treatment, and they have had more access to resources, so that they formed established committees and started planting crops. Also, solar energy has been introduced in some parts, like in North Kordofan and in some parts of River Nile State, to improve access to manage the water in a better way, and more cheaper and more cleaner, of course. Other interventions, including provision of butane gas cylinders, of course, training the people, raising their awareness, involving all the other stakeholders, especially the local government and unions of farmers and pastoralists. So the main impacts were improving the livelihoods of all those communities through the different adaptation interventions. The challenges are that Sudan is a very vast country, and there are lots of non-climatic factors impacting on the livelihoods of the people, like the abject poverty, like some of the governmental policies were not favoring actually the small producers, especially the pastoralists and the small farmers. Of course, the sporadic rainfall, the droughts, the large distances, the inaccessibility of some areas also impact the livelihoods of different people, different communities. As such, these are some of the challenges. But the project, the NAPA project, and now the CEDA project have given some hope, at least to these communities, to improve their livelihoods, and have given some model which could be replicated and upscaled elsewhere in the country.
What did you learn from exchanging with the other team during this workshop?
The workshop was quite useful and fruitful, because it's mainly from practitioners from different countries, and what they've reiterated, what they have said is related to their project implementation. I've learned a lot about using, for example, SMS for early warning. Then from the Cambodian experience in organizing women, in involving the private sector into provision of services from our colleagues in Western Africa, the projects into climate indexing. Sudan is now just started a new project in climate insurance and indexing. This is, have given us some insights into what these countries are up to and the difficulties they are facing, so that maybe the project in Sudan will make use of these experiences, as it is only starting right now. So, and I see possibilities of future cooperation and work with different projects in different other countries.
Thank you for your time.